Yes, you are watching Mokosi for live. This is the live reaction, live fan reaction show. You know, this is unprecedented again. You know, this is just our season. You know, it's just been like this the whole time. I don't know how else to just sum it up. We're getting Hunter on the line. We're gonna get some more fans on the line. Let's hear what the fans have to say. I had a lot to say in the live watch along. Thank you guys for those of you who did come on and watch with us. But yeah. So I don't know. The game was good for us in the first half, but the second half was poor. I'm just waiting for some fans to come online. We can hear what they have to say. What do you guys have to say? What do you guys think of the Kaizer Chiefs performance today? I thought it was absolutely poor. You guys can let me know in the comment section what you thought of Kaizer Chiefs' performance. Did it look like a team that could beat Pirates? Did it look like a team that could beat Sundowns? Does it look like a team that could finish in the top eight or at least the top four? Let me know. Let's see. Anyway, Matlatse, Mohale, Captain Aguero, we are on. Honestly, I did not expect anything from the guys. I was surprised. Many chances wasted. We should have won the game. Baleni says, we should have won the game. I'm so mad that Manyama, Nukovic, and Gazana for being wasteful. I agree with you, Baleni. Thank you for watching. Baleni also has a football channel, guys. If you guys are watching, and if you know or have seen or heard of Baleni's football channel, go and subscribe. Go and check his channel out. He also does fan reviews. I mean, he also does live match reactions, post and pre-game match reactions and match previews and reviews. But yeah, I agree that there are too many chances wasted. We should have won the game. And Manyama and Nukovic definitely were wasteful. And Gazana should have finished there. But here comes Hunter. I want to put him on. Add to stream. There we go. What's happening, brother?
Hey, man.
I can't hear you. Damn it. Hello?
Yeah, I'm still on.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I think I can hear you.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I think I can hear you now.
There we go. Okay, that's better. Okay, I'm being all fancy. I've got like a mic and stuff. So I think it wasn't working anymore. So okay. Anyway, let's see. But guy, I read some of your comments. I read some of your comments, and we'll get through that now. We'll get through your comments. Mm. But tell me what you thought of that game. Our first Soweto derby of the Premiership season. We've already played them twice, you know, in the MTN 8, and we got absolutely crushed in those games. Mm. What do you think about today's game?
Today's game was totally different, and in the sense that we had a brand new, or should I say a new look, Kaizer Chiefs squad that was more hungry, that played with intent, that played with the will to want to win. And I can say the score is not necessarily a true reflection of our performance, because really we should have been 4-0 in the first half, and then we should have finished them off in the second. But the one thing that I can pick up about Kaizer Chiefs is that every time that they concede first, they either they fight for a draw or they end up losing. And the last time they actually fought from behind, it was against Polokwane City in the bubble. And in that game, we did not play very well, to be quite honest. But today's game, no, we played very well. Honestly, we did. We gave everything. It was just we were showing cracks in the midfield. Manyama as well, in as much as I've been giving him a lot of stick in the past, but today he should have done better. That miss was unacceptable and unforgivable. And especially in the sense of a Soweto derby, you should be burying such chances like that. And then you get the likes of Nurkovic as well. He needs to sit himself down and ask himself, does he really want to put the team first or not? Because in that moment, we all know who's the usual penalty taker. That is Cardoso. So why did he insist? Why did he insist on taking the penalty?
Was there any conversation? I didn't see any conversation happening between those two.
In fact, what actually happened, in as far as the replay is concerned, is that Nurkovic had the ball. Initially, Cardoso was walking forward to want to take the penalty, but Nurkovic insisted. He insisted that no, he's got this and he's going to do it. So I got really, really nervous because I've never seen Simon Nurkovic take a penalty in my life. But
But
I was just so confident that he was going to bury it. But when he kicked that penalty, he just wanted to kill the keeper. He wanted to kill a forward.
There's a lot of power in that shot.
Yeah, there was. There was a.
So I'm gonna say it was a good save.
In fact, like that. No, it was a good save by Ofori. I can give him props for that. But all I can say is that the follow up was just shocking. Ngezana, I just don't know what's up with him, especially when he's playing in derbies as well, because he has not been playing well every time he has been playing in the Soweto derby. The only time he's played well in a Soweto derby was back in 2017 when we drew 0-0 to Pirates. But when we lost 3-1 to Pirates in the second round,
I don't remember that game. Did he actually play in 2017 in the derby?
He did. His first Soweto derby was in 2017. And this was directly after we beat Sundowns 2-1 in Loftus, and he scored his goal on debut. So, and in that game, Ngezana should have scored had that ball not hit the upright. But going forward, Chiefs, the only thing that they have themselves to blame for is the lack of conversion of opportunities. But as far as gameplay was concerned, we were the much better squad.
How many more games are we going to keep going like this, though? Every game, we keep...
You see...
You keep saying it's the same thing every game. How many more games are we just going to keep missing opportunities? And exactly. What do we do about it?
Exactly, Mish, because these are the kind of games where we were supposed to be really comfortable in front of goal. We're supposed to be ruthless in front of goal. This is our 15th game now. Straight after today's game, we are now heading on to the second round of the season, and that is where it's going to get even more interesting as well. So we are 15 games into the season. We are on 18 points. We are on 8th place. And we're only on 8th place because of AmaZulu's win last night. Had AmaZulu not won, we still would have been 7th. However, we need to really... get this thing right. Now our next game is against Richards Bay.
AmaZulu again.
We're playing
NetBank Cup.
Yes, NetBank Cup, because after NetBank Cup, we're going to CAF now. Yeah, we're going to CAF. We're going to Morocco. And it's only going to get difficult by then. But
and with these kind of chances we keep missing, I don't think anybody's going to do us any favors. It's not going to do us any favors, and other teams are going to be like, oh, these guys just miss chances now all the time. So we just need to get, if we score, we can just get back in this game. We can win this game. So,
exactly.
I don't know.
It all boils down to the mentality, Mish, because even on my radio interview on Thursday at church, that I actually told him that the reason why Sundowns were able to succeed for three seasons running, and as far as winning the league is concerned, it's all because of their mental strength. That is something both Soweto teams did not have. And that is why I commended Sundowns for. So we needed to learn from Sundowns in as far as the mental strength is concerned. So today's game, we were supposed to have that mental strength to say, look, we may go in as the underdogs, but we need to make sure that we finish the job no matter what. It is going to get messy. It is going to be scrappy, but we needed to make sure that we get the job done. But it was just so unfortunate that we had to play the game of catch-up. We managed to get that goal. That goal by Cardoso was really, really needed. Yeah. And it was going to give us a lot of hope.
Got the draw.
We could have. We could have gotten a draw, because the moment Lord scored that goal, I was like, oh, here we go again. I think we're going to go for a draw. That's the only thing that I was having in mind. It was a draw, because coming back from behind just to win, it was just really unlikely, unless we had that mental strength to actually do so. So the guys shouldn't disgrace themselves. They played very well. Pirates, they were really suspect in defense again. And
Pirates, that was my thing, right? People are gonna go, obviously the Pirates fans are gonna go on about how they beat us for the third time this season,
yeah,
and how they are the kings of Soweto now, whatever, right? I think they need to be honest, and also everyone needs to be honest, that Pirates didn't look great today. They didn't look like a team. They didn't dominate. We dominated this game.
Yeah. So exactly.
Yeah, I guess, but goals win you games, and we didn't score any goals. You know what I'm saying? So
exactly.
That's the only thing.
You know, it's just a few Pirates fans that actually admitted after the game that, you know what, these guys did not play well at all, and they can consider themselves lucky that they actually came away with a 2-1 scoreline. This is a game that Pirates should have lost. Yeah. I mean, obviously those that are busy bragging about how they are the kings of Soweto are those that are actually relieved that they actually won. Because just imagine if it ended up in a 2-2 draw. They would have really had a go at Pirates, saying, yo, how can we let our lead slip and all. But look, those who know football very well and who have watched the game closely will actually get to realize and actually admit that, you know, our Chiefs were the better side. The only thing that let them down was the result. They didn't get to convert the chances that they were supposed to convert. And we only have to move on from this, and we can only hope that we get them next time, which is on March the 21st. And I'm really hoping on that on March 21st, when they come to the Chiefs Kingdom, we really get those 3 points that we so much desire.
I see a lot of hate. And I think it's trending already. Manyama is trending. A lot of people hating on Manyama.
Yeah, yeah.
Could he have done anything better, or was the team as a whole? I don't think it was so much his fault. I mean, we love to blame one player or single out a player in every game.
At this moment in time, it's really not a good time to actually single out players because there were a lot of players that actually missed sitters, not Manyama alone. Manyama, what he did in that moment, yes, it was really unforgivable. It was unacceptable. But look at who's this, Ngezana. He had the most obvious
goal.
Chance.
There was open goal. There.
Yeah, Ofori had no chance there. And Ngezana just fluffed it, and that's when he knew that, you know what, he messed up again in the derby. So we can only have ourselves to blame for not converting our chances. That's what I'm getting at. So honestly speaking, we cannot single our players. Let us look at how we got to perform, and we got to perform very well. But in as far as chances are concerned, now we really need to work on them now. where we cannot be going into 15 games into the season and not be converting these chances.
We have to, do you think also another was a bit of a surprise for me, the inclusion of Mashiane later in the game instead of starting him was an error on Gavin Hunt's part?
It was because
you saw how important he was when he came on.
He was very important, you know. He was very important. And I was actually expecting Mashiane and Castro to actually start. I was, because, you see, I knew how leaky Pirates' defense really was. Nyauza's not that great. Tyson, in as much as he is deemed as a colossal defender, but he is clumsy. He is clumsy, for real. He's clumsy. And Jele can have his days as well. So we needed players with big match temperament. And I strongly believe that had Mashiane and Castro actually started, we would have seen a really, really different result. We would have seen a different performance from Kaizer Chiefs. And I can say that Gavin Hunt needs to sit himself down with the technical squad and say, look, had we started with this kind of starting lineup, we would have probably got a different result. And he needs to really take a look at videos, all right? I've heard of him being an old school coach and all that. Look, you cannot afford to be an analog coach in a digital era. That we cannot afford to have an Arsene Wenger at Kaizer Chiefs. We can't.
Whoa.
We cannot.
Arsene Wenger is a legend. Let's not even put the two names together. I would take an Arsene Wenger at Chiefs. Come on. You're an Arsenal fan.
But I know I'm an Arsenal fan, but I know what I'm talking about, because Arsene Wenger, during his last years as manager at Arsenal, he still had that analog mentality that let Arsenal down. And most of the teams in the Premier League, they were all digital. They had managers that had a digital mindset as well. Yes, he's a legend. I respect him. But we can. What I'm saying, that the main point I'm saying here is that we cannot afford to have an analog manager in a digital era. Meaning, we cannot be having a coach that does not do video analysis. Because that's where I was getting
it. Video analysis?
We were told he was not doing the video analysis.
Who told you this?
We've got sources. We've got sources.
A team like Chiefs with the most money in the country and the best training facilities. How can he not be using? No, man, come on. Do you think Zwane and Dylan Shepherd are not using video tech?
I have no idea, but I can tell you we have been told. We have been told. In as much as I did not want to believe what we were being told, but that is what we've been told. So what I am warning Hans is that, please, if it is the case that he's not a fan of video analysis and all that, he's really setting himself up for disaster, because really we really need to perform. We really need to catch it up.
I don't know who your sources are, but I have to disagree with you a bit, but I don't think a team like Kaizer Chiefs would allow him to even do that. I don't think Bobby would allow it.
But you know what? We should expect massive changes at the end of the season, and as far as playing personnel is concerned. So But going back to this season, because we are focusing on this season, Hunt, we cannot fault him on the game himself. But the guys really needed to go the extra mile to actually win this game, and they didn't. We cannot fault Gavin Hunt for that. I know people are pointing fingers at Gavin Hunt. I'm like, no, you cannot point fingers at a guy that actually wanted to win the game. He showed that he wanted to win the game with the kind of substitutions that he brought in. In fact, you know what was so interesting is that he got to replace some of the players that were not performing, and he got to bring on the guys that he trusted that they were going to perform, and they did get to perform. You know, they did get to perform. In as much as I still would have wanted a Ngcobo and Mashiani combination.
Yeah, that would have been better. I don't know why I took
it would have been better.
Ngcobo and Mashiani, they work. We've seen in the last four games they work. So I'm not too sure why he did that. That was a poor decision, I must say.
It was a poor decision, but you see, Pirates, the way they scored their goals, they only capitalized on our mistakes in the back. So that is the only reason why they got to win. But other than that, nah, Pirates weren't that great on the day. And I know supporters of Pirates are not going to hear any of it, but it is what it is. It is the truth. Chiefs were the better side. And the only reason why they did not get the results is because they didn't get to convert their chances.
Ah, all right, man. Thanks, Hunter. Thanks for your time.
Nah, you're welcome, my man.
Thanks for your support. And yeah, yes, man, we'll see you the next game. It's unfortunate we didn't get the win. But yeah, we still stay Amakhosi for life. We're still Amakhosi for life. And
you know what?
It's not the end.
You know what? Due to today's performance, I can still sleep in this jersey. I can still sleep in this jersey tonight, for real.
Yeah, because our performances are getting better. We just need to finish.
Of course. We just need to finish. That's all we need to do. But I can tell you, I am so excited about what's going to be happening next season. And as far as playing this personnel is concerned, I just can't wait, man.
Sure, my brother. I'm going to see for life.
I'm going to see for life, man.
Sure, brother. Is Mishak there? Hey, my brother. How are you? Ooh, I can't hear you. I can't hear you, brother. Hello? Hello? Just maybe put your volume up. Can you hear me? There we go. I can hear something. You can hear me. But I can't hear you. So maybe there's a mic. Let me try this way. Can you unmute your mic or something? Let's see. There you go. Hello?
Oh, can you hear me now?
Oh, it's very soft. Yeah, you're very, very soft. Sure. Hello?
Can't hear me at all.
I can hear you very softly though. Hello?
Let me call again.
Is there like a volume button that you can put up there or?
Yeah, everything about like.
I can't hear you, Mishak. Sorry, brother. Ish. Can you? Is there any way that you can use your phone instead of your earphones?
I should try there, but it's not working. I take it off. I take them off. Can you hear me now?
Hello. Not working, brother.
Yeah, we can drop it. I'll try next time.
Oh, there you are. I can hear you now. I can hear you perfectly now. I can hear you perfectly now, brother.
That's weird, because now I'm not on. I don't know what's happening, because I can no longer see anything.
What did you do? It's working perfectly now. I can hear you 100%. It's weird. Okay. I don't think I can see Meshach. Let's see who else we can get on the line. Oh, fudge. Okay, anyway, Misha couldn't get on the line. I think there was something wrong. But I think we have some more people coming. I'm going to read some of your comments. Mahlatse said it was deja vu, the same thing that happened in the first leg of the MTN 8 Cup. We don't convert chances. The team is no longer playing the game since the return of Manyama to the 11. A lot of people blaming Manyama. I'm not too sure if he is the reason we lost today. I mean, the whole team kind of played well, and then there were chances that we missed from Nukovic. Manyama missed that one chance. We're going to blame everything on him just because he missed one chance. Gizana even missed a sitter. Worse. So, yeah. I'm a Pirates fan. My Chiefs should have killed the game, but it's football. Joel, thank you for being honest. Thank you for being an honest Pirates fan. I'm glad we have honest Pirates fans here. Very disappointed. Fact, Manyama is giving Chiefs nothing. Cabello, I don't know if Chiefs players actually watch entire games, or Chiefs fans, sorry. If they just wait for goals or they wait for mistakes, because Manyama was giving some good through balls, making some good opportunities here and there. So I'm not sure why you would say that. Anyway. The Chiefs back for ball watching, and why Kado was still playing center middle. Cabello again said that I agree, the defense is just shoddy. Our defense can be better, our defense can become better. We have the players. I don't know why Matoho was in the bench. I don't know whether he was being rested, whether he was injured, but Matoho is a much better center back pairing of maybe Age and Matoho than having, who was it? Cardozo. It was Age and Ngezana, I think. Yeah, and Froslow on the right. So, yeah, I would rather Ngezana. I mean, if it was Matoho and Cardozo, I don't think we would have made the mistakes that we did today. Wanyama, what a waste for nothing. Our coach is losing it. I mean, our coach did the best that he could. He brought on he started with a good team. The tactics were good. Everything worked professionally. Everything worked. I mean, everything was perfect. The lineup was fine. His substitutions, maybe I had some questions about Gavin Hunt's substitutions and about why he took out Ngobo and brought Moshiane. I mean, we should be playing them together. We are facing them in less than 7 games to come. 4 defeats in 4 months. Hey, Nobby Nobs, sister Nobby Nobs, thanks for watching. Yeah, you see, you're a great fan here. Yeah. I don't think we'll be 4 defeats in 4 months. I think the next time we play Pirates, we can beat them. How can you take out Ngobo, our key to a game to perform? Bolkanya, you absolutely light. Ngobo is such an important player. I don't know what the reason was for taking him off. I'm sorry, but would love to see Kune back because he can communicate better with defense. Kune has made too many mistakes. Okay, yes, Akpe made a mistake today, but was it his whole fault? Was it his entire fault of his? I don't think so. We would have been winning 2-1. If when they scored that goal. So, legends, please support Pirates on today. Chiefs is nothing these days. Ooh, sister Nobs. I saw 3 penalties. All 3 were supposed to be for Pirates. Okay, fair enough. Because you're alive. Thanks, you, Cabello. We can't hear you, brah. I am here. We're blaming the coach and Manyama for not performing in the game, and frustration I had in the game is not coach taking out of mobile. D don't blame. Okay, so don't blame one or two players. The team at the defense was to blame for some of those mistakes. Especially maybe the goalkeeper could have done better. Maybe we could have done better with Noble and Mashiani on the field. But it's all about timing now. We were just unfortunate in this game because I thought we played very well in the first half. And we just fall asleep when we have these laps of concentration. And so, yeah, it's unfortunate. I mean, you guys saw, if you guys watched the game, we could have done better. We just have to pick our heads up and move now. We play Richards Bay, I think, next, as I heard from our colleague there. Richards Bay, and then we play... Oh, and then CAF Champions League starts. We're going to Casablanca. It's Casper Wydad. I can't remember. Wydad, Casablanca we're playing. Sorry. So we have two tough games coming up. Richards Bay is not going to actually take advantage of us because they know that we're not at the best of our abilities. They're going to study us. And it's going to be tough to watch. It's tough to take in. As for our game in the... our next game in the Premier League, which is AmaZulu, we were actually lucky, very lucky to win that game. We won the game because of the single Nukovic goal. It was his first game back. It was great to see him back. But we should have done better. It's going to be tough. AmaZulu played well last night. Benny McCarthy looks to have his team sorted out now. They look like they got their shit together. And they're obviously going to be stronger and better the next time. That game's going to be here in Joburg. So we'll see. I mean, I think the bulk of what we need is there. It's just we need to take our chances. But anyway. I'm Gosi for Life. Thank you for watching. Keep watching Amagosi for Live. Stay tuned. Yeah, we have more interviews coming up with some more supporters. We're going to try and get more people on here. Follow us. We are on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook at Amagosi for Live, LIVE. LIVE. At Amagosi for Live. And don't forget, you can subscribe here for more Kaizer Chiefs content. And hit that like button if you like Kaizer Chiefs, if you love Kaizer Chiefs content, if you like seeing more Kaizer Chiefs, and we hope to see more Kaizer Chiefs wins, smash that like button. Thank you for watching, of course, for Live. We will see you in the next one.